and the pines all scented in somewhere that's green.
When they get on a train from Niagara and she can hear Choice Bells chime, the compartment is air conditioned and the mood sublime. And then they get up in Saratoga for the quarantine time. A place to develop a lot of rip, a lot of rip, a lot of post and nasal drip with the wheezes and the sneezes and the sonnets that really uplift. Come on, let the community property and a feeling she's getting too old. A place to develop a bad, bad
cold. To my dearest Robbie, I think we need
was a girl bird named Gertrude McClung, and she had the smallest leg and tail ever was. One droopy droop feather, that's all that she had. And oh, that one feather made Gertrude so sad. She curled it, she dyed it, she gave it a puff, she decked it with but it wasn't enough. For no matter what, it just was what it was. A tail that simply wasn't meant to catch the eye of an elephant. The one feather tail of Miss Gertrude McClung.
Time! has a blue paste necklace, which he thinks is really real.
I found it in the attic with my grandmother's name inside. It's my favorite possession.
It's her fancy.
It's my pride. This morning a bird woke me up. It was a lark or a peacock or something like that. Some strange sort of bird that I'd never heard. And I said hello. And it vanished. Flew away the very second I said hello. It was mysterious. So do you know what I did? I went over to my mirror and brushed my hair 200 times without stopping. And as I was brushing, my hair turned mauve. From honestly mauve. And then red. And then some sort of deep blue when the sun hit it. I'm 16 years old and every day something happens to me. I don't know what to make of it. When I get up in the morning and get dressed, I can tell something's different. I like to touch my eyes because they're never quite the same. Oh. Oh.